How's the weather right now? I'm trapped in a digital world, so I can't really tell. But you know who does weather? Katie Tutrone.
I'm Katie Tutrone, and you can't spell meteorologist without me. And tearologist. Don't you wish you could touch a cloud? But it's so far away. Well, now you can, because I'm going to show you how to make a cloud in a bottle. A cloud is a bunch of air molecules that have condensed into liquid water droplets. What happens is warm air rises, and when it rises, it expands and cools off. And as it cools off, these liquid water droplets form, or clouds. This process is called condensation. Water droplets need a particulate surface to condense onto. You can't see them, but our sky is filled with these little particles floating around like dust, smoke, or even salt. The water droplets condense onto these particles. It's just like when you see dew condense onto grass. Here's what we need to make a cloud in a bottle. A bottle, a particulate surface for the water droplets to condense onto. I'm using rubbing alcohol. A bike pump to create warm air inside the bottle. And I've got a cork attached to my bike pump to create a nice seal. First, I'm going to coat the inside of the bottle with a little bit of rubbing alcohol. The rubbing alcohol provides a particulate surface for the water droplets to condense onto. Make sure you coat the entire bottle. Your cloud will thank you. Now I'm going to add air into the bottle to increase pressure. Increasing pressure will create all these collisions of air molecules inside the bottle, which increases energy in the form of heat. You'll feel the bottle start to expand, and it's very tight. A cloud! When I took off the cap, air molecules rapidly escaped, reducing the temperature and pressure inside the bottle. This cooling effect caused the water vapor to condense onto the alcohol particles. That's when we see the cloud. Some people like to keep their clouds as pets. I like to set mine free. Goodbye, Fido.